We're taking a long bus ride from Taranto, Puglia, and this episode heading west into beautiful Calabria to visit the absolutely magical Tropea. Andiamo! Tropea is a small town with a population of about 6,500 people, located in the province of Vibo Valentia, on the coast of Calabria, southwestern Italy. The town is situated on a cliff overlooking the Tyrrhenian Sea and is known for its stunning beaches, historic architecture, and delicious cuisine. Legend recounts that Hercules founded the town upon his return from his labors at the Pillars of Hercules, today's Strait of Gibraltar. Visitors will find the hero's name gracing the main square, Piazza Ercole. The origins of the monastery date back to the 6th century, when a group of Basilian monks are said to have settled on the small island and built a church there. Over the centuries, the church and monastery were repeatedly damaged and destroyed by invading armies and natural disasters, but they were always rebuilt. Today, Santa Maria dell'Isola is one of the most popular tourist attractions in Tropea, thanks to its stunning location and beautiful architecture. Tropea has a rich history that dates back to the ancient Greek civilization. The town was later conquered by the Romans, Byzantines, and Normans, each leaving their mark on the town's culture and architecture. During the Middle Ages, Tropea was an important center of trade and commerce, and it played a significant role in the Crusades. In the 19th century, however, the town became a popular tourist destination and has remained a popular spot for visitors ever since. The old town perches as a balcony over the sea. Tropea's antique palazzi are built right onto the edge of the rock, whose face drops straight down to the beach below. The church dates back to the 6th century, although the current structure was built in the 11th century and has been an important place of worship ever since. The church is located on a rocky outcrop that rises above the sea and can be reached via a staircase that leads up from the town. The views from the top are simply breathtaking, with stunning panoramic views of the sea and the surrounding coastline. The Santuario di Santa Maria dell'Isola is also home to a small museum that houses a collection of religious artifacts, including ancient icons and relics. Visitors can also take a guided tour of the church and learn more about its history and significance. Did you know that I'm a travel advisor? Going to Italy or perhaps to another bucket list destination? I'd love to work with you, so feel free to contact me for more information. The monastery is also surrounded by beautiful gardens and offers stunning views of the sea and the surrounding coastline. It's a great place to relax amongst the beautiful flowers and lush vegetation to enjoy the beauty of the Italian coast. The Giardini del Santuario di Santa Maria is also a popular spot for picnics and relaxation, with plenty of benches and shaded areas where visitors can sit and enjoy the beautiful scenery. The garden is particularly beautiful in the spring and summer months when the flowers are, of course, in full bloom. The town is best known for its beautiful beaches, which are situated at the base of the town's cliffs. The beaches are surrounded by crystal clear waters and are perfect for swimming, sunbathing, and water sports. Some of the most popular beaches in Tropea include Spiaggia del Canone, Spiaggia di Tropea, and Spiaggia della Rotonda. The Spiaggia della Rotonda is situated just below the old town of Tropea and easily accessible from the town center. The beach is characterized by its crystal clear turquoise waters, fine white sand, and the unique rock formations that surround it. It's known for its picturesque views of the coastline and the Aeolian islands in the distance. Spiaggia Rotonda is a popular destination for tourists and locals alike, especially during the busy summer months. There are many beach clubs, restaurants, and bars in the area, offering a variety of food and drink options, with the beach also offering water sport activities such as snorkeling and diving. The port of Tropea has a long history and has been an important center of trade and commerce since ancient times. Today, it's primarily used for fishing and recreational activities. This viewpoint is named after the large cannon that is located there and offers stunning views of the town's picturesque port and surrounding coastline. Canone Vista Porto is situated on a rocky promontory that overlooks the port and is a popular destination for tourists. Visitors can climb up to the viewpoint and take in the beautiful views of the sea and the town's colorful houses and historic landmarks. The church dates back to the 18th century and is considered one of the most important Baroque buildings in town. The Chiesa del Gesù features a beautiful facade with intricate decorations and is known for its stunning interior. The Convento dei Padri Redentoristi was founded by the Redemptorist religious order in the mid-19th century. The order has a long history in Tropea, and the convent played an important role in the religious and cultural life of the town. In addition to its beaches, Tropea also has a number of historic attractions that are worth visiting. The town's most famous landmark is the Santa Maria dell'Isola, a stunning church that sits atop a rocky outcrop overlooking the sea. Other notable attractions in Tropea include the Norman Cathedral, the Palazzo Vescovile, and the Museo Diocesano. Tropea's historic center is a medieval maze of streets which cuts a straight path down to the viewpoint out to the sea. Cafe tables fill the squares, and shops offer a wide range of local products. The Affaccio del Corso is a small square located in the heart of Tropea's historic center. The square is named after its location, which offers a beautiful view over the sea and of Corso Vittorio Emanuele, the town's main road. It truly offers some of the best panoramic views over the sea. The town is known for its delicious cuisine, which features fresh seafood, locally grown produce, and traditional Calabrian dishes. Some of the most popular dishes in Tropea include swordfish, octopus, and anchovies, all of which are caught locally. One of my favorite Italian joys is to take part in an aperitivo, which is a pre-dinner drink and snack. Here I ordered a lovely glass of Prosecco and received these complimentary bites. And then later at dinner, enjoyed some of the local pasta, vileia alla tropeana, followed by a secondo of petto di pollo e funghi. As mentioned, Corso Vittorio Emanuele is the main street of Tropea, and it was named after the King Vittorio Emanuele II, the first king of a unified Italy, and it's one of the town's most important and bustling thoroughfares. The street is lined with beautiful buildings, elegant shops, and lively cafes and restaurants, making it a popular destination for everyone. The street is particularly lively in the summer months, when visitors from all over the world come to enjoy the town's beautiful beaches, warm weather, and vibrant atmosphere. Overall, Tropea is a charming town that offers visitors a perfect combination of natural beauty, history, and culinary delights. Whether you're looking to relax on the beach, explore ancient ruins, or indulge in its delicious food, Tropea is definitely worth a visit. Piazza Ercole is also home to several cafes and restaurants where visitors can enjoy traditional Calabrian cuisine and take in the charming atmosphere of the town. Throughout history, Tropea was also involved in some major historical events. In the 16th century, the town was attacked by the Ottoman Empire, and a large number of its residents were taken as slaves. Tropea has also played a role in the Risorgimento, the Italian unification movement, and it was the site of a major battle in 1861. During World War II, Tropea was occupied by the Germans, and it suffered significant damage during the conflict. After the war, the town was rebuilt, and it became the popular tourist destination from the 50s and 60s. The place of worship suffered many damages over the years due to numerous earthquakes in the region. The beautiful Norman Cathedral actually has two undetonated World War II bombs near the door. It's believed they didn't explode due to the protection of the town's patron saint, Our Lady of Romania. A Byzantine icon of the Madonna hangs above the altar. She is also credited with protecting the town from the earthquakes that have since pummeled the region. This viewpoint is situated near the town's cathedral, which dates back to the 12th century. The Belvedere offers beautiful, breathtaking views of the coastline, the sea, and the town below. It's easily accessible by foot and just a short walk from the Centro Storico. It's most popular at sunset when the sky is painted with vibrant hues of orange, pink, and red. Tropea is sometimes referred to as the Pearl of the Tyrrhenian Sea due to its natural stunning beauty and picturesque location on a cliff overlooking the sea. Tropea was crowned Italy's Borgo dei Borghi, or the Village of Villages, for 2021 during the annual ceremony broadcast on Italian state television channel Rai Tre. The red onion of Tropea has been cultivated in the area for thousands of years and is an important part of the local culinary tradition. It's used in a variety of dishes and known for its sweetness, which is due to the mild climate and rich soil of the region. Today, the red onion of Tropea is protected by the European Union's Protected Geographical Indication designation, which recognizes its unique flavor and cultural importance. The onions are so important to the town's economy and culture that they actually have their own festival, which takes place every August. Besides its onions, other local specialties include nduja, a spicy spread made from pork, capocollo, a type of cured ham, and pecorino, a type of sheep's milk cheese. The square is surrounded by beautiful historic buildings, including the Palazzo della Cultura, a neoclassical building that houses the town's library and cultural center. There are also several cafes, restaurants, and shops around the square. Throughout the year, Piazza Vittorio Veneto hosts a variety of cultural events and festivals, including musical concerts, art exhibitions, and food festivals. The square, however, is mostly a popular spot for evening strolls and socializing with friends. Via Umberto Primo is a pedestrian-only street, which makes it ideal for a leisurely stroll or a bit of shopping. The street is narrow and winding, with charming alleyways and hidden courtyards waiting to be discovered. Some other dishes I tried during my stay were the lovely zuppa di cipolle tropiana, polpette alle cipolle, and not local, but still delicious, the pasta carbonara. This convent was founded in the 16th century by the Franciscan order and has served as a place of worship, contemplation, and education for centuries. Today, the convent is open to visitors who want to learn more about its history and architecture, and you're able to visit the chapel, cloisters, and living quarters of the friars, which are still decorated with period furnishings and artworks. The Discesa Ospedale is a scenic viewpoint and roadway known for offering stunning panoramic views of the town and the surrounding coastline. The viewpoint is situated at the top of a hill overlooking Tropea and can be reached by a steep and narrow road that winds throughout the town. The Spiaggia Mare Grande is one of the most popular beaches in the area, known for its soft white sand and clear blue waters. The beach stretches for approximately 2 kilometers long along the coastline and is surrounded by high cliffs and greenery, providing a picturesque backdrop for sunbathing and relaxation. There are also a few beach clubs and restaurants along the shore, offering a range of food and drink options. The beach itself here is long and wide, with fine white sand and shallow turquoise waters that are perfect for swimming and snorkeling. The beach is surrounded by cliffs and lush vegetation, giving it a secluded and peaceful feel. Here, visitors can also rent umbrellas and sun loungers to enjoy a relaxing day at the beach. On most days, you're able to see in the distance the Aeolian Islands, which are a volcanic archipelago in the Tyrrhenian Sea. The archipelago consists of seven main islands and smaller islets, with its main islands being Lipari, Volcano, Stromboli, and Panarea. I hope you had a wonderful visit to Tropea on our first stop in Calabria. Until next time, alla prossima! Did you enjoy this episode? Please hit the like button and subscribe to be in the know for future episodes.